The shadow fold. A scar on the map. That tore our country in two.
And we gone.
I fell in love with Shadow and Bone.
Bring the light.
Every chapter had a propulsiveness to it.
For this show, we've taken the stories of Shadow and Bone, and we've taken the characters of Six of Crows, and we've brought them together in this really extraordinary way. Shadow and Bone takes place in a world very much inspired by Tsarist Russia of the early 1800s. And this country, Ravka, has been torn in two by a swath of darkness called the Shadow Fold. To the north, you have Fyerda. To the south, the Shuhan. And these borders are constantly shifting depending on who is winning or losing a war.
Alina!
In the Ravkan First Army, we find our heroine, Alina, and her best friend, Mal. They are really grunts of the First Army that feel a lot like cannon fodder.
When did you get in?
Yesterday. Everyone's getting their assignments.
They've been through everything together, both brought up in the same orphanage, and they're both in the army.
Their relationship is so true and earnest. They really, really do care about each other.
If it goes wrong, come back.
Ravka has really failed to industrialize, so they're not going to win this fight in the long term. But the thing that has kept them safe is not the First Army, but the Second Army. This is made up of people known as the Grisha, and Grisha have unique powers.
There are three principal orders of the Grisha: the Etherealki, the Materialki, and the Corporealki.
The Etherealki are summoners
who essentially can manipulate the elements.
Fire, water, air. The Materialki are fabricators, and they can manipulate physical materials and chemicals.
And then you have
Corporealki. They can manipulate the human body itself. They can heal you or speed up or slow down your heart rate.
And then you have General Kerrigan, commander of the Second Army, who is the one person who can manipulate shadow and darkness and use it as a weapon.
The western side of Ravka is doing its best to sustain the east with various supply runs and whatnot, but the way to get anything in or out of Ravka quite often is straight through this fold.
Crossing the fold is potentially lethal because it's not only traversing a massive swath of pure darkness, but it's darkness that's populated by these creatures, the Volkra, who most definitely want to kill and eat you.
The one hope for Ravka is a myth called the Sun Summoner. And whoever he or she may be has the power to harness pure sunlight and banish the Shadow Fold forever.
Early in the story, Alina Starkov and Mal are attacked while crossing the fold. And Alina reveals a power to summon light.
She is the one. She is the Sun Summoner, which is extraordinary.
What this power does is put her on a collision course with some of the most powerful people in the kingdom.
Then we get to Ketadam, a place crammed with ruthless criminals and grifters.
This is where we meet the Six of Crows, led by Kazbrekker, the rising star in the criminal underworld.
In my gang, we have Jesper, who's the sharpshooter, and Inej, who is the wraith.
People want to make money in Ketadam, and the crows can con you in ways you will never, ever, ever know.
So this group, this gang, find out about Alina Starkov, who has just been discovered as the Sun Summoner. And so our story starts to interweave.
The prize is 1 million Kruger. Now bring me Alina Starkov.
Much in the same way that Stranger Things is always character-anchored storytelling against a backdrop of genre, Shadow and Bone is rooted against a backdrop of wonder and magic and adventure and scope.
We've got amazing stunt sequences and drama sequences, but also these really lovely human storylines.
They have built something that is going to feel incredibly familiar and that is so true to the heart of the stories, but is going to give the fans of these series something entirely new and thrilling.
Now the work begins.